The Faith at Work movement is on a cusp, destined for great things.
God uses people from all kinds of walks of life and all kinds of professions to advance His kingdom.
Work is a crucible that God uses to refine us.
Everybody's work matters to God.
The only thing that really brings lasting change is the gospel of Jesus Christ applied to every area of life.
Leadership is people who can take other people's pain and turn it into passion.
Are you overwhelmed by Jesus Christ?
It was 1977. Bill Pollard was a new vice president at ServiceMaster Corporation. And he was engaged in one of his very first tasks. He was mopping the floor at a hospital. He had just set out the sign that said, wet floor. People were rushing by. And a woman came up to him and she said, are you Bill Pollard? And he said, yes, I am. And she said, I thought you were a lawyer. And he said, well, I have a new job now. She looked confused, and she came up a little closer, and she said, is everything all right at home? It turns out that she was a distant relative of his wife's, and it was a very confusing time, but it cemented in Bill's mind that sometimes we create categories of work. We make one kind of work more important than another. That was a vital lesson for Bill as he sought to lead at the ServiceMaster Corporation. I'd like to tell you a little bit about Bill Pollard. He graduated from Wheaton College and went on to law school at Northwestern University. He then took a position in practicing law for 9 years. After that, he went to Wheaton College as a vice president and faculty member. And then he went on to a 25-year career at ServiceMaster. I want you to think back with me to 1977 when he was doing this. The Faith at Work Summit in 1977 would have been pretty small. This was a different era when there wasn't quite the support that there is today. And it's my privilege to tell you that I think Bill, gifted by God, had figured out a lot of what it is that we are struggling with today. And we would benefit by going back and looking a bit at his life. I want to consider three questions for Bill. One is, how did he think about his work and his faith coming together? The second question is, how did he communicate that? And the third one is vitally important. How did he recognize that his work and the work itself actually shaped him? In doing this, I would like to follow three books that Bill wrote. And I'm doing this for a very specific reason. I can only sketch what he did, and I'd encourage you to look further. So the first book is The Soul of the Firm. And in this book, he outlines what it was that he did. Now, there are many, many topics in this book, but I want to focus on two. One is a theme that he had was people should be the subject of our work, not the object of our work. What that means is the leaders in an organization should be about developing people and not using people. Now, this played its way out in many ways at ServiceMaster, but here's one. Dave was a recently hired MBA, and his first assignment at ServiceMaster was cleaning the baseboards at the new wing of a hospital. As he was carrying out this work, two nurses walked by, eager to see the new place where the hospital had expanded. Dave looked up and warmly greeted them and said, hello. And it was like he was invisible. And Dave said that he paused and he thought, I'm an MBA. My wife is a nurse. And they didn't see him. And Bill said that helped to understand for all of the leadership to understand that sometimes people are invisible in the work that they do. How can we change the way we think about the people who do our work? But you know, it's not just about the relationships, even though that is very important. It's also about the work that they do themselves. He tells a story about Shirley, who was a housekeeper also at another hospital, 250-bed hospital. And Bill, as the leader at Service Master, would come through the area, and when he walked into that hospital, Shirley came up and said, "I want to give you a hug. I want to thank you for preparing me to do this job, and I want to thank you for the opportunity to serve in this way, because you know, Bill, I am doing a work that helps the patient get well." How did she know that? Well, I'm not sure how Shirley knew it, but I know how Bill worked in his in the hospitals. He shared with people by having doctors and nurses come in and explain to the workers, those people doing the bottom and toughest jobs, your work is a part of the health of the patient. And he has a chapter in this book on the purpose of our work and how our work is not just a task. It's not just that we do it faithfully, although it is that, but it's also that it has purpose and value. And it was his goal that everyone at Service Master, whatever position they were in, would see that purpose. Now you might say, well, this is a bit self-serving because if people see a purpose and understand they're valued, they're going to be cared for, and therefore they're going to work harder, and therefore the company will do better. But Denise Daniels told me the story of coming back from Laity Lodge with a group of people from a conference, and Bill was in the van. Everyone was excited and talking about the events of the conference, but Bill was deeply engaged in discussion with the young African-American woman who was driving the van, listening to her story about her work and her faith and how that worked. It was a part of who Bill was. The second story I'd like to tell you is based on the second book, Serving Two Masters. In this book, you need to understand the context. Service Master was a publicly traded company. One of their first objective of four was to honor God in all that we do. How do you share that with people that are of a very diverse background? When the company had people working in China, Southeast Asia, and around the United States in places where people were not Christians. And what Bill did in writing this book is explain to the board and to his people, there are 50 essays here, that talk about what it is to honor God in all that we do. It wasn't that he was imposing God on people, but he was opening up God to people. He talked about the fact that this is a God who gives dignity to every human being, who loves every person, who skills them and equips them and wants the work done. And he does this through a series of essays that are absolutely beautiful in communicating how he did his work. This book, however, has a couple of twists to it that I find really interesting. The first one is the title. Bill was handed the title by the publisher, Serving Two Masters, God and Prophet. And Bill said to the publisher, I cannot write a book under that title because Jesus said you cannot serve two masters. So in his negotiations, he added the question mark. And then he said, Reflections on God and Prophet, because he wanted to show how making a prophet was a part of serving God. And so he brings this economic component into this faith, work, and economics area. And I think this book is something that I would commend to you. I would say that Bill is a stickler for words. And the first time I met him, he was attending a talk I was giving, and I think I inadvertently used the phrase Christian business. And he said to me afterwards, Al, that was good, but I want you to understand that people are redeemed by Christ and that businesses are not Christian. Be careful in using Christian as an adjective. He's a stickler for words, and this book shows it. Third topic, I would like to show you how his work shaped his life. This is a wonderful book, an autobiographical book. I found out from one of his colleagues that actually he wrote this for his great-grandchildren, for people that he may never meet. He wanted to leave a legacy of how he had thought about this whole idea of faith and work. In this, you see something about his family. You see something about the heartaches growing up when he lost his father, when he couldn't afford to go to school, and a number of things that came along in his life. But he tells a story on himself that is profound. He tells about the time in 1977 when he was being interviewed by the CEO of ServiceMaster. And he went to this interview and they made a big pitch to him and they said, you know, there's a path to be CEO of the company. And Bill said, I pressed a bit too hard. He said, I started talking about, well, what will it take to be CEO? And Ken Hansen stood up and he said, the interview's over. And he exited the office. 2 days later, he got a call from Ken and he said, let's have breakfast. I want to tell you what happened. And over breakfast, he said to Bill, if you want to come and serve, you can have a great opportunity for a career. But if you want to come for titles and roles and it's about you, forget it. We're not interested. Bill said, I learned a lot about service and servant leadership at that place. We at this summit are standing on the shoulders of giants, and Bill Pollard is one of those giants. I would encourage you to get to know more about him, because what you'll find is those things that we're so excited about today, many of them Bill had thought about. I would also encourage you to read these books that I mentioned. I just so happen to have an extra copy of The Tides of Life. And this afternoon, after the first session, I will be over at the SPU table. And the first one that makes a really good story to me, I'd be happy to give it to you. Thank you very much.